Hey, what's up, guys? This is Bria Myles, and you are here on the Valentine's Day special edition, 21 Questions. Well, I could say number one, after definitely traveling around the world so much, I feel like I've had a very great childhood. I'll say that. You know, I feel like everybody goes through things, and once I realized that, I had to really sit back and think, like, okay, it's not so bad, you know? Like, I grew up, and look where I am now, you know? I feel like my mom did a very good job. She did the best that she could, so I feel like, yeah, I had a great childhood. And then, you know, to touch on what I was really starting off with, which was that I traveled around the world so much, it made me realize, like, I'm very lucky to have grew up in California, number one. Like, our weather is really great. We're always in the sun. I feel like, you know, being close to the sun is very, very, very powerful. And so that alone, you know, going to different places and seeing how cold it is sometimes throughout the whole year, some people's high schools, when I saw some of the high schools and like how they are, some of them look like office buildings, you know. My high school was very big. It was outside, some part was inside. Like, it was just really, really nice. Like, so honestly, I feel really happy.
Which is better, makeup sex or I miss you sex?
Ooh, what a question. let me think back to some of those times. Let me think. Probably makeup, because the passion in like just fighting and overcoming, I guess, you know, and that unconditional love that you feel you have for that person, or you should have if it's unconditional, always for that person. So it's just like once the fight is over, you just feel so good and happy and relieved. And I think it all comes out with like how sexual you are at that moment. All skin is the right skin. And that is the honest to God truth. And I think you should love the skin that you're in. And I went through that when I was younger. And to be real with you, my mom, oh my gosh, she always told me how beautiful I was. She always complimented me on my skin. My mom is lighter. She's not like extremely light. She would be like a caramel or like a tan. You know what I'm saying? But she definitely, you know, just always just made me feel so loved. And the thing about it was, is no matter how much she made me feel like that, I still had a stigma about my skin color when I was younger. I still didn't feel as pretty and stuff like that. So I think that that's really something that you need to deal within yourself from now. If you're feeling that, you need to get that out of your mind, and God will lead you in the path to, you know, being whatever you want to be once you deal with yourself and make sure that you love who you are. A sweet treat? Well, I'm not really that into sweets. I really like chips. Crisp, as I like to call them now. I love calling them crisp because I go to London so much and that's what they call them out there. I feel like it's so proper because they're actually crispy. So.
Right.
But... okay, so if I had to pick a sweet, no, because I don't like whipped cream. This sucks. I should be saying like whipped cream or something like that, but that would be like the generic answer, I guess you'd say. Yeah. Not the generic, because it honestly, I guess, you know, people really love it, and it does work because it's easy cleanup. Lick up, all that kind of stuff. But I would probably see, and everything I'm thinking of just don't sound right. Like, caramel is too damn sticky. Chocolate is just too thick and like, yeah, like messy. So whipped cream would be the best. So I let him put it on me. How about that?
Okay.
I let him put it on me. And then, like, I can just, you know, admire what's going on with him.
Yeah. What skincare routine do you use to keep your skin so smooth?
Aw, look at you guys. That's something so many people want to know, huh? No, I know that because a lot of people comment on my skin, so I know that that's something that people definitely want to know. So my skincare routine, because it's kind of a lot, and so it's like for me to like have to go through it, it's like I really want to give it so properly, but basic, I'll give a basic one. Instead of toner, I use rose water spray, and I get that from Whole Foods. So there you go, Whole Foods, there's your plug. I use a lot of rose water. I use that, it has glycerin in it, and honestly my skin is a little bit dry, and even though it doesn't look like that, that's because I make sure to, like, you know, overly moisturize. So the rose water that has glycerin in it, basically whenever I start to feel dry throughout the day, I'll spray it on, and it just makes me feel refreshed, and it, like, you know, rehydrates me. And so I feel like that's how I keep my glow throughout the day for sure. And then I use this face cream that's like a homemade face cream. I'm actually in talks about, you know, like trying to come out with, like, you know, something natural for people, because like the face cream that I use is like, everything is like from the earth, like essential oils, yeah. So I definitely wanna, you know, try to brand something like that, because I know a lot of people are interested in, like, you know, living in the skin that they're in, and that's what I definitely do, you know? I don't wear a lot of makeup, I let my face breathe a lot. And another thing that I think is healthy that a lot of people don't know, is also, like, for us, our black skin, like, we really, really should be tanning and, like, really sitting in the sun and, like, basking in it, because that definitely helps with evening out your skin tone and your glow. Like, it is like one of the best treatments you could ever, you know, do for yourself. We are like, we live for, we can receive it, so we should be using it for sure. I'd probably say like his chest, but like I'm into very, like, just, you know, here's the thing, because this is the thing, I don't like to place stigmas on what I'm into, you know? Like, I think I can adapt to almost anything that isn't, like, you know, unhealthy and not taking care of yourself, you know what I'm saying? So when it comes to a man's chest, I just like, you know, something that's very smooth, and, you know, that's pretty much it, like a nice smooth, it doesn't really, you know, we'll figure out the look of it later once I meet you. Thank you. Yeah, the skincare thing, like, I'm definitely looking to branch into that. And I'm telling you, like, here's the thing, like, I really feel like anybody can do anything they want to do. You know, Jessica Alba, like, she has a billion-dollar company with Honest Co., you know. And I just feel like, you know, like, why don't we have something like that? You know, like, it's there, you know. We should be, you know, branching out and doing much more. But also, you know, I have this campaign coming up called Run a Mile, and I'm going to be basically, you know, promoting an active lifestyle for people, because, you know, one thing that I did do, you know, was when I decided I wanted to lose a little bit of weight, I started, like, replacing, like, my car with, like, riding my bike or walking somewhere. Something was like under 2 miles or something like that, I try to walk there and back home. And then, like, if it was, like, you know, more than that, I try to bike back home and stuff like that. And then just kind of really use my car at night. And that really helped. It definitely did. So, you know, I want to just promote an active lifestyle so people can stay in shape, stay fit, you know, feel good about themselves. Just a few other things, too, but I'll get into that. You know, everything's just an idea right now, but so I don't want to, you know, speak up on it until, like, everything is, yeah, you know, near set. But I got a lot of great ideas, and I want to definitely share them with the world. And my skincare routine, that's number one. I want people to be able to live in their skin and love it, like, for sure, you know. So I'm definitely going to dabble into, like, all skin types, you know, things of that nature. Like, I just want everybody to feel good about themselves.
What's the boldest thing you've done through texting?
Boldest thing I've done through texting. Guys, I don't know what kind of question that is. Seriously, because I'm like, I mean, everybody's pretty much probably sent a nude to somebody. I've never sent a full nude to anybody, but, you know, like, I don't know. What would be like, I mean, I curse people out, not using curse words like that, but I definitely, you know, give it to them. So, I don't know. What have I done that's so bold through text? I can't even answer that question, I don't think. Sorry, guys.
I can agree, music video vixens had the industry unlocked in the late 90s and early 2000s. What do you think got rid of this movement?
All great things must come to an end sometimes, guys, and then the cycle just restarts at some point in time with a new idea that's similar to the old idea but has, I guess, you know, different things about it that makes it new and improved. But I'd say probably just the fact that, like, music first started being shared and people weren't paying for it, and so a lot of artists were losing out on money from that. And then you know, from that it was like a domino effect, like everybody underneath that started losing money because the top people who were supposed to be making the money weren't making as much. So I think that's what happened. So I think once we find a way for the music industry to flourish the way it did before, maybe even more, then everybody underneath it will be able to get paid with, you know, what they're deserved. And also, when you use quality over quantity.
Exactly.
Or when you use quality over somebody said, I'll take $200.
Unbelievable.
Yeah.
What defines a sexy man according to you?
Well, obviously confidence. That's a big thing with anybody. When I can see that they're very comfortable in themselves, it definitely makes me attracted to them. And then from there, it's just I have to get to, I don't know, connect with that person through something, and I can't tell you what that would be, you know? It could be something that they've said to me. It could just be like our eyes connected and we feel it, you know? It could be any things of that sort. I'm not really a picky, like, they have to be this other than well put together, you know, and take care of themselves.
What was your best Valentine thing?
I don't think I really had a really great one, unfortunately. That's so crazy.
What's your dream Valentine's date?
Well, Valentine's Day to me is a different type of thing. Because at one point, I definitely really believed that, like, you know, oh, take me out on this day, da 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 da. But now I really believe in just showing me that all the time. And it, like, I just really feel like every day, not putting too much pressure on anybody, like not saying you gotta buy me roses every day and put a card over here and then, you know. No, it's just the way you treat me and how we interact with each other. And then when this day comes, like, great, well, I guess we'll do, you know, a few special things and stuff like that. But, you know, I think the best Valentine's is being, like, you know, I guess, like, just in a very good place with that person at that time and, you know, hopefully continuing on. No, that's really wild because that's such a good question because actually I have a lot of male friends. Now here's the thing, I'm not naive. I know if at probably any point I wanted to go further. Davy down, but they're all mad respectful, and I think that they really appreciate my actual friendship, you know, which means a lot to me, like, to the point where they respect, like, the fact that we're just friends, you know. So it's not really hard for me. That's really crazy. I have a lot of guy friends. Mainly, I was just talking about this with my other friend yesterday. I was like, you know, a lot of times when I go to parties, I like, you know, dabble and say hi to all my friends because they're usually always there. And like, I just know a lot of the guys. Like, that's it. So it's just like, you know, it's always good. It's never a problem. It's been a problem before. Look, I had to think about that. Like, it's been a problem before, but you know, so far so good. I'd say a good 98 percentile, 95 to 98. You know, being a model, that always happens, to be real with you. So yeah, but it's never been a thing for me. It's never, like, to me, it's never accidental, because it's like the business that I'm in, like, it's just like a fashion show stage back, you know, backstage. Like, the girls are not like, they're like go time. Like, it don't matter who's looking, it don't matter what's going on. I gotta put this outfit on and I gotta get over there. So yeah, you know, that's happened before, but I'm really comfortable with my body, so I don't really care if people see me naked, straight, gay, nothing, it don't matter. Boxer briefs, that's it. Yeah, like any other outfits, like, just, I like when a guy just looks good, like, you know, but that type of stuff don't really turn me on. It's like outside of like that, yeah, after the mind and all that. But yeah, like, my favorite thing is to see a man like in his boxer briefs, like his outfits. I just like a guy who can dress. Like, you just have to have style. Yeah. Yeah, I need some good style.
Amber Rose is very vocal about the slut walk movie. How do you feel about slut shaming?
I feel like everything she's saying is correct. Like, I don't see anything negative or wrong in what she's doing or saying. I think that it's a very like, people don't talk about it. You know, and then it's the thing of like, whenever a woman defends herself and says, oh, but a man, then everybody is like, oh, well, you're just da-da. So I think that by her just taking a stand and saying that everybody's equal, it's true, you know, we're all humans, like, you know, male, female, whatever, like, we're all people and we're all humans. Color, skin color, like, that's the two things we all have in common.
Is it important for a guy to hear you, like, groceries?
It's important for a guy to just know how to, like, go with the flow, and like, it be like a nice movement, like water, so whatever happens, if the flip over happens and that happens, then cool. But yeah, you know.
Are you mad that we asked you one more question?
No, I'm happy. I wish you would have asked me more. I get to hear all day. I love this. I love talking.